still playing game of catch here, which is not easy. Paul! You can hear me okay. It's not easing off at the moment, which is not the best, but we'll get there. The guys are just out doing a sighting lap at the moment. Still being a bit of confusion about track layout. So before we start the 800 lights, at the 800 and 800 lights, they've taken the guys out for another little run. So let them get familiar with the track and the layout. We'll see how it goes. Kelly, you're not far wrong. Definitely Redcliffe. Somebody brings the Redcliffe. They brought it with them. I don't know who the hell it is. We'll see. See what happens. We're going to do the lights. So, the 800s. Fan club here with some of the racers. They're obviously going to get in the way as usual, so they'll block off part of the view, so I'm going to have to concentrate just on this half of the track around here. So see what happens. I can only do my best. Kelly, it's what we call back in Scotland is blowing a hooly. Blowing a gale. Hopefully they get started pretty soon. It's starting to go out. Fingers crossed. So we've got the 800 lights here, and Ben Morris is actually in from 800 cc's as well. They're just putting them all together. Just doing a little sighting lap first, get himself used to it, and then I believe they do the rolling start after that one. Excuse me for my sniffing, guys, my it is a bit cold here and my nose is running a little bit, so it's not the runner. So Marshall's bringing them round. Marshall's leading them around again. I hope you guys can hear me okay. Mind you can see it, you don't want to listen to me. So As you can see from the fixed camera, the skies are nice and clear, a little cloudy in areas, but the wind is just bonkers, no need for it. Hopefully get this race underway pretty soon. Put on some music for you, but I'd probably get shut down by Facebook, and I don't want to sing you a song while we're wet. You don't want to listen to me singing. Not good. Danielle, as far as I'm aware, all the skis are out there. Unless there's an issue with some of them, and they've pulled over, pulled out. Taylor Porter listed as 100. He's out in the water, I believe. I don't know about that one. It's on that one there. Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah. Unless he's jumped on another one. Well, I've got full lineup. All the ones that are ticked off on my list are racing, including Ben, who's racing his as well, Ben Moss. Apart from that, I believe we've got everything. Let me just do a check. Yep, we've got 8 racers out there. Raise the other camera, guys. Excuse me while the sound goes off at the moment. So there we go, I've got it a little bit higher. Oh, jeez. Yeah, it's picking up again. So the cameras might shake and move around a little bit, I don't know. But, I've raised the motion camera. I've raised that up a little bit. So hopefully it kind of gives people a better view. Actually, it does. It looks better on the track, actually. You can get a better view of it. Just you can torpedo those people that are just in the foreground there. That would be fantastic. But no such luck. But, I don't know when they're starting this light event. Hopefully starting it soon.
Thank you.
Yeah, they are. They're not doing them before each individual class, or at least I hope not. The idea is all the sighting laps first, and then just crack on with the racing. So there's a mixed number of people out there at the moment. There's no races at the moment, so I'm just putting us on for the moment. Let's see how, for me, to see if we can get the look. And also, so the reason you're seeing odd numbers and mixed numbers around is, we're not actually in the racing at the moment. Should be starting the racing shortly. So they're doing all the they're doing all the sighting laps before the racing begins. So different groups going out. Well, I sincerely hope that's the wind dying down. Jamie Eadie's ride of choice today in the Enduros. Osman Kawasaki. Nice looking ski. He's hugged up one. Anyway, enough of that. Back to what's happening. Thank you. think through the course of this weekend I might need Chuck Norris's sniping skills. Take out a few people. So we're just waiting on the guys getting the sighting laps out of the way. And then we can crack on with the each round.
Sit down, guys. Please in the water, ready to go. So we have Corian Scott, amateur Scott, and GP Runabout. Get in the water now, guys.
So they're just completing the sighting laps for every class, and then they're going to wait. Then they'll crack on with that. The 800 lights, the 800s and 800 lights. Just in case you're wondering what's going on, there's no racing at the moment. Just some laps to help the riders get the bearings and familiar with the track layout, so there's no missed, well, hopefully no missed corners or missed buoys. That's the waiting area for the next group to go out. All the riders have been told to, all the sit down riders have been asked to get on their skis and get out here. So they can get everyone else out and then they can get on with the ride, the racing, sorry. It's the last group of sit downs. Getting out there to join them. The last of the bunch. Then it's races. Race on. I think we're probably running a bit behind here. Might be wrong. Let's see. 10:30, yep, I'm probably about an hour behind at the moment. An hour behind. An hour and a half actually. 10:15 we were meant to start the MOTO ones. So yeah, we're running a little bit late, but I know there was a bit of a window where the wind was pretty bad, so I think it just delayed stuff. Delayed any of the riders out on the water. Kendall out there with Billy Briggs. Ash is racing for 81 Racing, New South Wales rider.
Thank you.
just when you think the winds have died down, back again. Holding on to the monitors again. Chilly, considering the afternoon is coming on, is coming up on us. To father and daughter then, Doug Porter and Taylor. Going for the bragging rights, that's what they are. So here we go, we're going to get cracking on with the, we're going to get moving on with the first of the main MOTO races. It's working good, apart from the wind. Want me to catch my monitor and stop this from closing? I know. I actually thought about a bit of duct tape and just duct tape it down onto the table. I thought, you can't do that. Just like that, the wind's back again.
You're good, Elijah. Tell us if you want a break, maybe over here.
Huh? Yeah, it's not bad. It'll be like this makes a big difference. The camera and controller.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm the Linda, I'm Charlie's wife.
Oh, okay. Yeah. It's cold. Yeah.
I've been watching you on your jet drive.
Yeah, well, it's been a bit hit and miss. It's been a bit, like I've had the tech issues that just, it's just little things that I just forget about, or they were working earlier and for some reason they're not working now, you know, when you go live.
Yeah.
It's a little bit frustrating.
Being consistent though, to keep on doing it.
I'm trying my best. Like, I wouldn't give up on it.
No.
I enjoy doing it, it's good fun.
Yeah,
I like it.
Oh,
you never know.
Yeah.
It's all going on to Facebook.
Oh, cool.
I'm not recording any of it. Yeah, I'm just live streaming it on Facebook, yeah. Yeah, I'm not recording any of it. I can download it later. Yeah. Well, I spoke with No, I was just saying that. Yeah, I was just saying that. I was gone and now it's back. Yeah. Oh, poor Jeff. COVID. COVID victim. You get some great pictures up here, Jeff. I'm fine with the setup I've got, so looking all good. Daniela, you got the bad deal there. Huh? Should have brought the dogs with you. Left Doug and Taylor at home. You should have came up. Monos. Oh, thankfully, Danielle, we were able to... yeah, Jeff, you're right. I think it is warm where you are, because it's not as warm. Not, certainly not warm here. I've got a beanie on, and I'm caught, and I've just been... And I got given one as well. I've got that on, and I'm contemplating putting on my other beanie on top. That's how cold I am. And I'm from Scotland. I'm meant to be used to this. So... So I think we're going to start the race. Let's see. And we'll see if I can pick out the names of the winners. The runners up. Jeff, that's a good one, mate. Can you, yeah. Can you hear that? Off. Eight hundreds and 800 lights. Oh, there's always somebody gets in the way. I'm not going to get that far corner because all the bodies. Ben is obviously in the lead. Ben Morris, he's leading his own class. Tell him a move.
I wish I could.
But then if I'm yelling in your ear, I don't want to be yelling at too many people. Ben Morris is leading it. He's in his own class anyway, so we're looking for the 800 lights and who's in that one. So we have
red flag out.
Red flag out. Red flag here. Red flag, red flag.
Yellow and purple before they go to the street.
red flag there. Missed some boys. On the wrong side of some buoys. So, looks like they're going to go a restart. They've had their briefing. Now it's time to restart. Is that what you want? You want to see the dam, Gabby? Is that what it was? So here we go. It'll restart. There we go. Yeah, I know they were. Because we're just waiting on the restart, Gabs. Oh, for God's sake. We're going the wrong way again by the looks of it. Hands are on the head. Charlie, sorry. Is there any way we can get these? Oh, these. If I can get a crack at the, if I can get a view of that corner, that'd be great. Guys, can I get you to move, please? Get you move back, please. Thank you. Cheers. Beautiful. That's it. Yeah. So, right where we are. Let's see there. Figure out who's in the lead and who's not. Right, so it looks like Ben Morris is potentially leading from front. Ben Morris has got second in the race itself, but he's won his class. Not really sure who that was. Oh no, he's not, sorry. Got another lap to go, my apologies. Let's see who's in the lead. Somebody's come off. So Anthony Murphy won. He won the 800 lights. Second in the 800 lights was Daniel Stenner. I'm not sure who that was. It was third. It might have been Doug Porter, possibly. Maybe I'm wrong. Danielle, you'd probably be able to help me out here.
Yes.
Ben won his class. He's the only one I know. Right, so Connor Tazakis Greece. He was third, I believe. Looked like he was third. We've got Ben won his class in his race. Daniel Stenner was second. And Matthew Gibbons, Anthony Murphy, I think I said it was first.
There's
Doc Lapps
in that one.
So Mr. Joker and two got docked. Oh, so there's
potentially people losing places. Yeah, there's 33 places changed.
Ah, okay. All right. Of course. Yep. All right.
I wish it was nice and cut and simple, but it never is. Yes.
Alright guys, we've got the naturally aspirated, got four in the list, so we'll see. We've got one guy, that's fine. Yeah, so we got four on the list. Oh, we got more than four out there though. No, there is four out there, five out there. Oh, there is four, sorry, my lies. My eyes deceive me. So, Brett Whitaker, we've got Troy Taskisaris, Seb Bahadurin, and Dean Kruskos. I think we've got a bit of a New South Wales battle here. Let's see who's where. Seb's second at the moment. Ollie Morris could be third. I think it's Ollie Morris. Not Ollie Morris. God, numbers don't correspond to the lineups I've got. Sebs is the only one. Oh. Second race, red flag again.
Guys, the track has been done incorrectly again by this class. Could everybody make sure, because from now on, I think we're going to have to make a decision that if you miss the grab the wrong way around the track, we just don't come on that track. So, everybody, please, if you're not sure, come get here in the afternoon. Right, everybody. There's no reason for you to go the wrong way. So, causing this traffic at the moment, that's not too much time.
Okay, so I stand corrected with the lineup. We have Brett Whitaker, number 74. We've got Ollie Morris, 811. Seb Bahadurian is 106. And Dean Kruskos is 333. So there is no Troy. Just kiss, I guess. Try it. Jeff, I'll get it more. Don't worry about it. Okay, taskmaster, Jeff. Yes, I can zoom in. The problem is the speeds of when it's near and they are moving fast, it's actually quite difficult to track them using the screen because obviously there's not much in the frame. Apart from the ski, and out generally outruns the lens close up. But if it's Daniela, that last race is potentially whoever were in the places would probably most likely going to lose the places because they've done the course incorrectly apparently. But I can only give you as in real time as I see them, but those results may change. Alright, so we're going to do a restart again because the red flag, incorrect course. Running behind. They're a good bit behind. Wind's dropped down a little bit, Gabby. It's not as blustery as it was. It's sporadic. It was pretty bad earlier. It's definitely calmed down a bit. Jeff, this camera is a business, mate. This is ideal for this. If we could get a couple of them, God, we'd be in business. Who wants to fund it? Guys. Coming into the penultimate lap. Jeff, just got to decide to make the investment. I think I'm going to need to sell both my kidneys for this lot. Anybody in the market for some fresh kidneys? See if our old Mr. Official in the way, Mr. High Viz. So who do we have? Dean, Seb.
So it looks like we had possibly Dean Kruskos
Who crossed the line first? Yeah.
So first was Dean Criscross.
Yeah, Dean Criscross crossed the line first.
Yep.
Then we've got Seb, and then we've got Ollie.
Yep, Ollie.
Ollie Morris, and then fourth Brett. Was Brett Whitaker.
Yeah.
Yeah, cool. Thank you. Yeah, definitely.
Makes me happy.
Yeah. All good. So here you go. So Dean Criscross takes the win on that one. Seb Buadurin takes the second. Ollie Morris got third. Brett Whitaker was fourth. Right, I think we're going juniors next. Yep, juniors next. We've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 9 juniors in this one. So, well done everyone. Should be a good one. Six heading out there at the moment. That's not quite all there is. Work out who these are. Oh, there we go. 2 latecomers, we've got 8 heading up. Alright guys, so we're going juniors now. We get the start. Sorry. I think we've got 8 in this. This lineup's got 8. There's meant to be 9, but someone's obviously either forgotten, not realised, or just dropped out. Somebody missed a memo on the rolling starts. There Yeah, watch what you say. Like that, is it?
Yeah.
Right, so we're having a restart. Guys overrun the runoff, the running start. So here we go. Picking up a head of steam now. It's just the overrun the runoff, so they had to, they ended up going back on the start for the roll. Ah, wrong way, shit. Sorry guys. Something just came off. Look at him gather, get himself on. Something sucks. Jake Wilson in the drink. Yellow flag on it. And he's back up again. Well done. Awesome. Good to see you. Yeah. I'll just check with the officials who they had crossing the line first.
So the late the winner was John T. Butterfield.
John T. Butterfield?
Yeah.
He crossed the line first?
Yeah.
Yeah? So John T. Butterfield crossed the line first. Any idea who was second?
Don't know yet.
Oh, right, okay. Yeah, all right. So at the moment, we've got John T. Butterfield, number 73, crossed the line first. Although some others crossed the line, we've still got to be determined as to what penalties they might have incurred. So once I've worked all that out, hopefully I'll be able to give you the result of that later. But at the moment, the only one that's definitely crossed the line first is John T. Butterfield. But again, he may have some penalties as well. I'm not entirely sure yet. So all right. So now we're on the wreck lights. Decent sized field in this one. We've got eight in it. Just pan round to that one. Okay guys, so wreck lights, eight racers.
Scoring first, then a drink.
So here we go, right? On the rolling start now. Wreck lights, here we go. That looks like they've gone back. Back again. Oh my word.
And let's see what happens in this one. But as I said, it's got to be behind the back of the start boat. The back of the start boat. So you'll see has to be behind it, alright? So please have a thought about it, you know? If someone next to you is trying to move themselves forwards, don't go for it, because you've got to pick one next and do the right thing. You will get a lot taken off it. See that then?
And they're off.
Nudging out then, so they're all trying to get up there. So, guys, I'm calling out, we're going to start taking a lap off you, so concentrate.
And then I didn't get the last one.
guys, if anyone's hungry, the great Martin family have got opportunities hooked around the back of the caravan here. So if you're hungry, come up and get something to eat while on the caravan. There's a barbecue just barbecue cooked. So come on, guys, get up here and have something to eat and fill your stomach.
Christian Collins might have won that one, though. Get the officials to confirm that. My apologies for not being able to pick out the numbers myself. I'm too busy trying to operate this stuff, operate the equipment here, and make sure I can get you as best a picture as possible. But I'll confirm with the scorers. I think Christian might have got the first place on that one, Christian Collins. As to who came second and third, I'm not entirely sure, so... Looks like Christian may have crossed the line first, but he's been missing some buoys, which has cost him the race. So, so red lights. I'm trying to get you get any numbers for that one? Did you get any numbers for crossing the line there?
No, that was...
I know it's 42 cross the line first, but he may have... he was on
three.
He's missing boy.
Yeah. There was about three of them, but he did multiple.
Right, yeah, well, I heard the conversations there, yeah. So, in fact, I think the conversation might have been streamed live. certainly from a visual point of view, it was right in front of the camera. You could just see Christian going.
Well.
Right, so amateur stock now. Who's in this one? Let's see.
How are you?
Right, so yeah, so we're going to start the amateur stock. Billy Briggs is in this one. Dave Matchett, Eddie Fowler, Lucas Sandrin, Tate Simon, Mark Dallow, and Ash Kendall's in it as well. And Troy is meant to be in it, but I think he's probably a scratch because he hasn't been in any of the other races. So here we go. Oof, and they're off. Boom. Somebody's roaring ahead. I don't know who that is. Let's see if we've got a look at it. Okay, so penultimate lap's coming up. This one. Good one, though. Conditions for some of them. I'll just check with the officials again.
Can you bring anything up from the wreck lights race out on that back yellow buoy?
Just had a request to play back some of the video footage for a dispute on the course earlier on, but it was all live. If it went, if I was capturing it at the time, it might not even be there available, so they maybe have to look at it and check and see. But I can't guarantee that I've actually captured them the moment he's missed it. So. Alright, so that last race there, we had we had a mixed race, pro-am stock and amateur stock, pro stock and amateur. They combined them both. This next one here is beginners, five entrants: Scott Gibbons, Tim McCoy, Jason Mulberry, Jason Lair, and Mike Anderson. So let's get this underway. They're off.
Okay, so women are out there at the moment, guys. Can we please have 1500
maybe Scott Gibbons here that's in the lead in this one. Jason Lair's in third. It's probably. Let's see what we've got.
Yellow.
Tim McGee, he's fourth. Four in this race. So Tim McGee, Scott Gibbons is winning, or leading it. So let's see who. Jason Wales dropped out for some reason. Issues. So down to three. Down to three at the moment. Not on that lap. Somebody's lost position. So it looks like Scott Gibbons won it. Take a look at it.
Dubbo.
I'll look it up. Give me a second. So is it Cam?
Cameron. Martin. Yep, PDS. Yep. And so on up, if you go up on this page, so the second story here is why the CJ and the Enduro. And that's the story that I wrote.
Perfect.
Big system.
All right, cool. Thanks for that. the way to start. The way to start the women's.
Yeah, they start now.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, thank you.
Alright guys, sorry about that. Distracted. Alright, so we're on the ladies. Ladies race. Let me just get it, track it down. Here we go. So he's out. Carly's got the lead at the moment. It looks like Tracy Bennett's out. Alicia Dalrymple is third. So we've got three left in the field. Carla's got her nose in front at the moment. Oh, we've got a red flag. That's what happened down. Yeah, it looks like it's a stuff up, so it could be. So we're going for a restart. Yep, restart here. Red flags are out. Somebody has missed something causing the red flag, so Tracy's her way back up over the far side to restart, so so it looks like we're going to have a restart with four racers now. Nobody's dropped out at all. So here we go, restart. Hopefully I get this one right this time.
We will be stopping for a quick break in a couple of rounds, in a couple of races. We'll be stopping then just for 20 minutes to give the all the safety guys and that.
And there they go. Somebody's got a flyer.
Get something now if you want to.
Somebody's missed a marker, by the looks of it. Tracy's in the lead. She's got the lead now. It'll be half. Carla's had a nightmare. Still having a bit of an issue. Tracy's way ahead. You got a cracking start. Tracy's got the lead. So the girls are actually quite far back. Thanks, Ian. got Alicia, looks like she's in second. Johanna's in third. Carla is coming up the rear. Stena, she's just had a bit of a bad issue, a bit of a mishap when she was coming around the first lap. And she's put her on the back foot right from the start. Tracy's going hard. So Tracy Bennett's leading. Alicia Dalrymple looks like she is potentially, she looks like she's, Johanna Christofferson's taking second place at the moment. Alicia's third. And Carla is falling up the rear at the moment. She's not giving up. She's keeping going. So Tracy's on her penultimate last lap. She's getting a white flag, so one more to go for her. Looks like she's going to take this, barring a mishap. Last lap for Tracy, last lap for the rest of the girls as well. Joanna's still in the lead, still in second. And the wind decides to pick up, and I'm having to hold the monitor. So, fingers crossed, doesn't cause an issue. And Alicia and Carla just not that far behind. Alright, here comes Tracy. Charging. So Tracy Bennett wins it. Johanna Christofferson will be second. Alicia Dalrymple is going to hold on to third place. Carla McLennan comes in fourth. Nice race, ladies. Nice and clean. One for Tracy there, she got a cracking start. And Carla got a cracking start on the first one as well. She was just unlucky to hit the rerun. Otherwise, Carla could have potentially taken the win. But hey ho, it is what it is. Any given day. I got that one alright.
Yeah, but that one was fine.
Eh?
That was fine.
Yeah.
That was fine.
Yeah, it looked nice and clean. That was the easiest one.
Yes.
That was the easiest one to commentate on. Because I'm familiar with these girls as well. I'm familiar with some of the riders, but men riders, but not all of them. There's a lot of them I don't know. So, the more I get involved and the more I get to go to it, the more I go to some of the events, the more I'll get to know them.
I hope all my talking's not down over the live stream.
Huh? Of course it is. They got Christian's conversation in the front of the camera. Although I don't know if it was heard. I don't know if it was heard about that. But All right, guys, we're on the 1500s. Wiseman or Westman. Oh, it looks like he's leading this one at the moment. Sorry, guys, I'm having to hold my wind's blowing up again. Wishman. Cameraman. Got him, I'll fire him. So it looks like we're, yep, possibly Clint Wiseman. We got first, and I think possibly Cooper Beekman got second. Jess, who are we having that? Is it 1-2-2?
No, it's 18.
Cooper? Oh, 18?
Yep,
yeah, Cooper. So Clint won, yeah.
81, Hayden
Erickson. 1-2-2. And Cooper, yeah, okay. All right, cool, thank you.
Nice.
Yeah. So we have Clint Weisman, 1-2-2, he won the 1500s. Hayden Erickson comes second. Cooper Beekman came third in that particular event. So now we're on to the GP ski. I've only got four on paper, but it looks like we've got five in race. So we obviously had a late one. So let's have a look. On the roll now, they're about to start.
Here we go, guys. Here's the GP ski.
GP ski, five entries. They're off. They're more, man. More up. I'm going to miss all the action on the backside, so apologies for this, guys. Not the best. Get the official See if there's an official confirmation on the finishes.
Jake's
definitely first. Okay. All right, guys, you heard that one. Jake Beekman's first. The rest of the guys have still got to be determined as they missed buoys and stuff, so their positions have still got to be finalised. But Jake Beekman definitely won that one. So thanks for that one. Thanks, Jess. So we've got the GP runaround now, runabout. Paul Baisley, Billy Cunningham, Rowan Sharples. Justin Belkowski. Scott Phillips. And Jamie Eady. Thank you. So Belly, looks like Belly Cunningham's the clear one on here. That mile. Yep, first place Belly. Change a ski from somebody we're not entirely sure what the Justin. Red flag for some reason. Not entirely sure why. Okay. It's a break time. You guys are all, I think we're going to grab a bite to eat, drink coffee or whatever. Break time. Alright guys, that's MOTO 1 finished, and hopefully we get MOTO 2 done pretty quick because we're running a bit behind and got 4 rounds to do still. We're 1:30 p.m. and we've only got one round done. We should be at round 4 by now, so we'll see how we get up rest of the afternoon. Alright guys, listen, tune in for round for MOTO 2. I'm not entirely sure how long of a break we're having, but we'll keep your notifications on if you want a feed, if you want to get notified when we're coming back on. I'm gonna sign off on this one just now, and then you guys can tune back in later on. Alright guys, enjoy your lunch, whatever you're having at the moment. I'm off to have a bite to eat. I'll catch up with you shortly. Thank you.